Well, the obvious one is Thomas. I mean, yeah, that's the one, because you... Yeah. We don't want to say too much, because it'll ruin it for you. Yeah. But what's great is it gives another depth to the film, you know, that there's a lot of pomp and majesty and cinematically it looks fantastic. But there's a real heart to this story and a real proper need for it to be told, I think. You know, we won't go into why, but you'll see when you see what it is.
It was great for us. We're in... What day is it today? I'm jet-lagged.
Monday.
Monday, is it? Last Monday. It was only last Monday that the premiere was in London, and we were all there. We've never seen Downton Abbey with an audience, of course. Like most of you, we see it in our sitting room at home on a Sunday night. So to see it with an audience was fantastic. Yeah. And to see the effect of... To see people laughing and applauding and cheering and really getting into it and enjoying it. But the great thing for me was to see Maggie Smith's lines with an audience. And I think Julian Fellowes is writing at his best when he writes for Maggie. And of course, she knocks it, if I can use a slight Americanism here, she knocks them out of the park.
She really does.
Yes, that's good. Yes. So to see that with a live audience was just great. And I think you saw the best of Julian and Maggie in this film. And that's not giving anything at all away. It's a treat for those of you who haven't seen it.
And also,
right?
Maggie and Penelope together have never been. They're on fire, aren't they?
Penelope.
They are on fire.
Let's not forget, we all talk about Dame Maggie Smith, but she's Dame Penelope Wilton as well.
I mean,
she's a
new Dame.
You know.